Alami, which is about to be launched. Sir, very good to have you on Parnas River. First of all, what made you write this book? What was the inspiration behind this book? Can you talk a bit about that?
The inspiration is that, sir, today I'm a writer, and all the time stories are there in my mind. This is a love story, a sensitive love story. When it comes out of me, I must write it. And after the writing it, and it just was ready. You know, I'm into fiction. I don't want to write Bollywood biography.
And how much time did it take for you to write this book, and when did you start writing this book?
A few months. It took me something like 6 months in a month.
Okay. There are talks that Mahesh Bhatt is going to launch the book, and also Shirish Pundar is going to launch the Kindle edition. So, how did that happen, and how did you approach both of them?
Sir, I got Mahesh Bhatt to launch my book because he is a man who has lived his life at his own town. He is a creative man, a thinker, and a man I respect.
Yeah, so this film, this book I have read that it's about a guy marrying a rich girl to get famous. So is that the reason why it is called Color Me Rich?
See, true that this artist marries a rich girl, but he is not some cunning, conniving man who is searching for a rich girl, wanting to be a toy boy or wanting to be a trophy husband. It is his destiny that he falls in love with a girl who is rich, and that girl also falls in love with him. That girl is an art collector, as well as an artist. So it's not his dream to be rich, but he has always thought that being poor and worrying about money may be affecting his work, may have been affecting his work. So he thinks if he was free from money worries, it could be better. Whether the money helps him in being more creative, in being more prolific, in painting more, or not, is the question you will find the answer in the book.
Can you give us two or three reasons why people should read this book?
I will give you one reason for reading this novel or reading any novel. See, when you watch a movie, so it is a lazy entertainment, it's audio visual. You are just relaxing and enjoying a story someone else is telling you. But when you are reading a novel, then you are using your imagination or your senses to connect with the story. I think that is a more intelligent way of listening to a story. A movie is being told to you by somebody else. And when you read a novel, you are reading it, you are participating it, you are connecting with the reader, and you are using your own imagination.
Do you think book reading is slowly dying with internet, with mobile phones, with technology? Do you think so?
Exactly. And that is why my book is smaller in size. If you take a look at this book, so this is smaller, anyone can finish it in a couple of hours. People becoming Twitter oriented, Facebook oriented. Today, nobody has the time to read big, thick books of 500 or 600 pages. Nobody has the passion for that. So my book is an answer to that.
Okay. Any advice to young writers which you want to give? What should they follow?
One advice I would have for the writers. If you are young, maybe 22, 23 or something, don't just jump into writing. You first live a life. Life experiences give you the stories that can be more readable and that can be more interesting. If you just write about your first love affair, about your first heartbreak, and think it is, and you have become a writer, then you are only dreaming. Then you are going to have only one book, that first book.
Okay, thank you very much for talking to us. Hope the book is a great success, and all the very best. Thank you very much.